the depths of the sea. Creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the song that we sing.
Anointing is coming upon me.
The Nehemiah anointing is coming upon me.
Say the Nehemiah type of anointing is coming upon me.
The Nehemiah type of anointing is coming upon me.
Tell three people.
The Nehemiah type of anointing is coming upon me.
The
Nehemiah type of anointing is coming upon me.
Are they ready? Are they ready?
Yes, Lord.
Are they ready?
Yes, Lord.
I am going to put the Bawaut Avacho very ready.
Yes.
Koiwewe Wacho, are you ready?
Yes.
If you are ready, shout, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
If you are serious, lay your hand upon your head.
Yes, Lord.
Father, I pray for everybody who is here. Father, may this anointing for impact.
Yes, Lord.
That we are praying for in the year 2014, as it comes to an end,
yes,
as we approach the year 2015,
yes.
Father, you have decided it upon my heart that this is the grace that you want to put upon your people's lives.
Amen.
May it be received, oh God, even today as we are ministering.
Yes.
The word that you have embedded with this grace,
amen,
as it is going to them, may this grace be received in Jesus' name.
I receive.
If you believe, you are the first one to begin to see change because of this anointing. Clap your hands to Jesus.
Yes, 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 Lord.
Now, I want you to go to the book of Nehemiah. The book of Nehemiah. The book of Nehemiah, chapter number 1. Somebody say, an anointing. For impact. Is resting upon me. Now, chapter number 1, verse 1. Are you there? The words of Nehemiah, the son of Hakaliah. And it came to pass in the month Chislev, in the 20th year, as I was in Shushan, the palace, that Hanan, one of my brethren, came, ye and certain men of Judah. And I asked them concerning the Jews that had escaped, which were left of the captivity, and concerning Jerusalem. And they said unto me, the remnant that are left in the captivity, they there in the province are in great affliction and reproach. The wall of Jerusalem also is broken down, and the gates thereof are burned with fire. And it came to pass, when I heard these words, that I sat down and wept, and mourning certain days,
amen,
and fasted,
amen,
and prayed before the God of heaven.
Amen.
How many are still with us in this prayer and fasting?
Yes.
Oh, if you are fasting today, wave your hand, wave your hand, wave your hand.
Yes.
May God anoint you with this same anointing.
I receive.
Verse 5 says, I beseech thee, O Lord God of heaven,
amen,
the great and terrible God, that keepeth covenant and mercy for them that love him and observe his commandments. Let thine ear now be attentive and thine eyes open, that thou mayest hear the prayer of thy servant, which I pray before thee now, day and night, for the children of Israel, thy servant, and confess the sins of the children of Israel, which we have sinned against thee, both I and my father's house have sinned. Verse number 11. O Lord, I beseech thee, let now thine ear be attentive to the prayer of thy servant, and the prayer of thy servants, who desire to fear thy name, and prosper, I pray thee, thy servant this day, and grant him mercy in the sight of this man. For I was the king's cupbearer. Now, chapter number 2, verse 1. And it came to pass in the month of Nisan, that 20th year, in Artaxerxes the king, that wine was before him, and I took up the wine and gave it unto the king. Now I had not before time, I have not been before time set in his presence.
Amen.
I have not been what? before time said in the king's presence.
Are we together?
Yes.
Wherefore the king said unto me, why is it thou come thy countenance sad, seeing thou art not seen? This is nothing else but sorrow of heart. Then I was very sore afraid, and said unto the king, let the king live forever. Why should not my countenance be sad? Somebody say, why should not my countenance be sad?
Why should not my countenance be sad?
Oh, say, why should not my countenance be sad?
When I am not married,
when I'm not married,
when I'm poor,
when I'm poor,
when I'm still renting,
when I'm still renting,
when I'm wearing rags,
when I'm wearing rags.
So Nehemiah said, why should I not be sad when the city, the place of my father's sepulchres, lieth waste, and the gates thereof are consumed with fire? Then the king said unto me, for what thou make request? So I prayed to the God of heaven, and I said unto the king, if it please the king, and if thy servant have found favor in thy sight, that thou wouldest send me unto Judah, unto the city of my father's sepulchres, that I may build it. And the king said unto me, the queen also sitting by him, for how long shalt thou journey be, and when wilt thou return? So it pleased the king to send me, and I set him a time. Can I preach about the Nehemiah anointing for impact in the year 2015?
Yes, Papa.
Sit down. This kind of an anointing is dangerous. I said this is a dangerous type of an anointing. That when it rests upon you, you will accomplish things that have never been accomplished in your generation. When this grace comes upon you today,
yes, Lord,
there shall be a place somewhere that you shall go and do something. And after finishing, people will pass through that place, and they shall surely not pass without their eye being attracted to what you will have accomplished.
Amen.
There is a certain thing that I am assured of after this message.
Yes, sir.
That you are going to accomplish.
I receive.
For your generation, you are going to break a certain record.
I receive it.
I said in your time and in your age.
Yes, sir.
You are going to break a certain limitation.
I receive it.
That even the world will look at you and say, surely there is somebody whom God has anointed in our time.
I receive.
If you believe it's you, can you stand up and make some noise under the door?
Yeah.
He's able to anoint you. Now sit down. Can I preach this message?
Yes, Papa.
Now, if you study your Bible, you will discover there were three Nehemiahs in the Word of God. But only one Nehemiah stood out. There were three Nehemiahs being called by one name, which carries one meaning and one significance. They were all under one God. They were all Israelites. They were all worshipping the same God, under the same anointing and under the same covering, in the same time and in the same year. But one stood up and stood up. I decree and I declare,
yes, Papa.
You shall stand out if you are grouped among them.
I receive.
I said you shall be elevated. The Bible says, thou shalt be elevated like a horn of a unicorn.
Yes, sir.
Which means you must have this desire to stand out among a crowd.
Yes, sir.
That later, I am tired of people who look at their neighbors and think what is happening is normal. If it is not biblical, it's not normal. If the walls are broken, even if there is nobody who is saying this is not normal, you should stand up and say, if it is not what God said it would be, I am going to be the one who will stand up and build this wall. For if it is God's will, God will prosper me in doing this thing.
Yes, sir.
Do I have somebody who wants to stand out here?
Yes, Papa.
I said, do I have anybody who wants to stand out here?
Yes, Papa.
I mean, it's talking about standing out and saying,
somebody is seated down.
I said, do I have anybody who wants to stand out?
Yes, Papa.
You shall be counted among your generation.
I receive it.
I said, you shall do what others will be failing to do.
I receive it.
You shall have an eye that sees error and correct error.
I receive it.
You shall have an eye that sees beyond, below limitation, below quality, and you will go for quality.
I receive it.
Uchasumuka mtenzareni uona zikusina kumila mushe iwa wosu tukwa sanduzi.
I receive it.
Uchasumuka kumusha kwenye uona nyayetsi wana kukatiris kwa wakati katiris.
I receive it.
If you want to stand up.
Yes, Lord.
You are my listener today.
Yes, Papa.
I said, if you want to be counted.
Yes, Lord.
Among the rest.
Yes, Lord.
And you will be seen standing out.
Yes, Lord.
I'm not going to speak to a lot of people.
Yes, Papa.
And I'm talking about inside as one group.
Yes, Lord.
In any video, I'm hearing a group that is really right in and it is one group.
Yes, Lord.
Inde kada akusumu kandono nakarushindo.
Yes, Lord.
Inde kada akusumu kando chata.
Yes, Lord.
Inde kada akusumu kando waka.
Yes, Lord.
Ino itenga mota yo niri wana uta.
Yes, Lord.
Inde inde kada inde wana uta shisina kuboitwa.
Yes, Lord.
Aripo erano I want to stand out.
Yes, Papa.
Shout, I want to stand out.
I want to stand out.
I want my head to be seen among the rest.
I want my head to be seen among the rest.
I want my name to be spoken among the rest.
I want my name to be spoken among the rest.
You.
Me.
I said you.
Me, Papa.
I said you.
Me, Papa.
I said you.
Me.
You shall stand out among the rest.
I receive it.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Are you seeing? Isn't it amazing? If I had not told you there were three Nehemiahs,
yes,
you only thought there was one Nehemiah.
Yes, Papa.
Why? Because when you do something,
yes, Lord,
you overshadow every other person who is in your generation.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
May you, I don't know what you do.
Yes, Lord.
I don't know what you do, but here is what I'm declaring upon my life right now.
Yes, Papa.
In my own area.
Yes, Lord.
In ministry.
Yes, Lord.
I will be the major.
I receive it.
Yeah.
I take it, Papa.
I don't know you in your own area, but as for me.
Yes, Papa.
I decree and I declare.
Yes, Lord.
I thought you were going to copy me. I said in my area.
In my area.
I decree and I declare.
I decree and I declare.
I am going to be standing out.
I am going to be standing out.
Among the rest.
Among the rest.
I choose to be number one.
I choose to be number one.
I don't want to be the second.
I don't want to be
I
the second.
I choose to go on top.
I choose to go on top.
If they talk about my family.
If they talk about my family.
They will talk about me.
They will talk about me.
If they talk about my father's house.
If they talk about my father's house.
My name shall be standing out.
My name shall be standing out.
May that be your portion in a few minutes.
I receive it.
Sit down. Can I show you something from this scripture?
Yes, Papa.
Nehemiah. Uh-huh. What makes a person who has got one name with others, in the same generation with others, serving the same God with others, under the same grace and under the same anointing with others, to stand out? There are things that you need to understand today. I'm not going to waste time. I'm going to go straight to my point. There are things that you need to consider. There are things that you need to look at. Using this same scripture, there is a certain character, there is a certain attribute that was upon Nehemiah that made him to stand up. Hello, somebody.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor,
if you don't stand up,
you will wear out.
If you don't choose to stand up,
you will become history.
As for me,
I choose to stand up.
I choose to stand up.
So, number one, if you want to stand up, this is what will attract the Nehemiah type of anointing, what I'm teaching you. If you want this grace to be upon you, if you want this anointing for impact to be upon you, I know a lot of people think God just anoints people because he's the God who anoints people. Let me tell you something. For an anointing to be upon you, you should be doing something.
Amen.
You are not just anointed to become something. You do something, then you are anointed to do it with ease.
Amen.
I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody.
Oh, yes.
So, Do you know that when we look at Nehemiah, we can look at him as a man who had a great vision, who had a great dream. But can I shock you? Nehemiah didn't saw a vision of himself building the walls that were broken. Neither did he dreamt of himself building that wall. Neither was he prophesied that you are the one who is going to build that building.
Amen.
Because if it was so, we were going to say it was preordained, it was pre-planned. But let me shock you. There is an attribute that I want you to possess today.
Amen. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Amen.
That caused God to anoint Nehemiah with an anointing for impact.
Yes.
Can I drop it?
Yes, sir.
The Bible says these are the words of Nehemiah, the son of Hakaliah. Huh?
Yes.
He says, one Hanani, one of my brothers, or one of our brethren, came from Jerusalem, and he was asked, he was what? The state of the remnant that is kept in the captivity, and the state of Jerusalem is the city of God. By those who were kept captivities. On that note, can I show you something?
Yes, sir.
There is an attribute that I've also seen before I go to this one. This guy is the one who is coming from where the problems are. The destructed war and the people who are in great suffering. But he is coming and he is being asked by people who are in captivity. The state of the two. And among those who are in captivity came out one who stood out and built the wall. Yet there were people who were in Jerusalem who were free, who were not captured. So if you think it is captivity that will sometimes hinder you from accomplishing great things for God, you are lying. It's you. Because number one, you might not even be captured. Because there were people who were in Jerusalem. There were people who have even escaped. But they did nothing about the situation. I lost somebody.
Amen.
But it took somebody who was in captivity.
Oh, yes.
Who was in Babylon to travel. I don't want anybody to come from somewhere to go and sort out situations that are in my area. I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody.
Yes, Papa.
Do you want to be anointed?
Yes.
If you see a situation that needs to be sorted out, stand up and say, God, use me.
Yes,
we cannot wait for an evangelist from the UK to come and heal the sick in Zimbabwe.
Yes,
I am here. Anoint me to heal the sick.
Yes,
we cannot wait for a prophet all the way from the United States of America to come and prophesy people's issues here.
Yes,
I don't know you, but I'm standing up to my God.
Yes,
and I am crying to my God, anoint me with this anointing to make impact.
Yes,
wherever there is a situation that has been sorted out,
yes,
I am there. Wherever there is a building that needs to be built,
yes,
I am there. Wherever there are sick people to be healed, I am here. Wherever there are dead people to be raised, I am here. Wherever there are people in prison to be visited, I am here. Somebody shout, God!
God!
I am here. Anoint me to do this mission.
I am here. Anoint me to do this mission.
Why do we expect donors to come and do things yet we are here?
Yes, Lord.
To be a donor doesn't even mean you was blessed and you are now able to do it. Why do we wait people who cried for that anointing from overseas to come and sponsor us? The same God who gave them money should give somebody money to take care of every situation in Zimbabwe.
Yes, sir.
I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody.
Yes, Papa.
If they have it, where did they got it?
Yes,
if the Bible says, if heaven does not give, men shall not receive anything.
Yes,
it means whatever they have, they were given by the heavens. If I also under the same heavens with those in Australia, with those in UK, with those in the United States of America, I shall call upon my God and my God shall open the heavens for me.
Yes,
and pour out a blessing that will cause me to also become a blessing to others.
Yes, sir.
I'm not going to wait for anybody from anywhere.
Yes,
I don't know you, I don't know you. I'm feeling this in my spirit.
Yes,
we don't have to wait for anybody from anywhere.
Yes, Lord.
God can use you.
Yes, Lord.
Are you ready?
Yes, Papa.
Are you ready?
Yes.
If only God can send. If only God. Why can't you change your prayer and say, God, let me be the solution? Today I want to sort out somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Do you want money?
Yes, Papa.
Do you want to be rich?
Yes, Papa.
You were only paid for a problem that you have solved.
Yes, Lord.
Yet the problems that are there, you are crying to God to send somebody to solve them, yet you are poor. Your money is in the situation that is in need to be sorted out.
Yes.
That's where your money is. Oh, sit down, let me help you. Money does not answer to crying. Money does not answer to tears. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, Lord.
Money answers to solving situations.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Do you know that even here, me, I've got money. Right,
yes,
now, where I am, even the person sitting next to you, he has got money in his pocket. But you are looking for money. Why is it that the money in his pocket is not coming into your pocket? You have not solved any problem for him. So you are crying. At the same time, you are crying for somebody to come and do something. I know I'm speaking to myself right there. So Nehemiah said, do you know that what rescued Nehemiah from being in captivity was the desire to sort out the situation somewhere?
Yes.
He had never thought of asking the king to release him to go back to Jerusalem. But when there was a need to be sorted out, he then approached the king and he said, allow me to go. But you are a captive, but there is a situation that needs to be sorted out. If there is something that is in disorder according to God's plan, that thing, if you desire to sort it out, even the hands of your captors will release you. The reason why you are still haunted by witches is because you have not determined to solve a certain situation somewhere. You are just crying, release me, release me. When you are released, what do you want to do? If there is no reason why the king has to release you, you will never be released. If there is no reason why those who bewitched you has to release you to go and accomplish, forget, you will pray, you will fast. Whatever you will do, God will not answer your prayer until you say to God, God, how can I be a prisoner? Yet the walls have fallen down. How can I be poor? Yet the church is still hurting. How can I be sick? Yet the gospel has to be preached in Mutare. I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody right there.
Yes, sir.
If there is no divine purpose, if there is no situation that you want to be in alignment with what God desires it to be, you will remain a prisoner. But today,
yes, Lord,
may God put a burden upon your heart.
I receive.
Now sit down. So a lot of people are waiting to dream. Let me correct it. And a lot of people are waiting to be prophesied what they should be doing in life. A lot are waiting to receive an open vision. You have prayed and prayed and prayed for that to happen and it is not forthcoming. Why? Because God is speaking in another way that is not a dream. Another way that is not prophecy or a vision. There is already a situation. Why is it you have seen there is a problem? That's God speaking to you.
Amen.
If you are clapping for Jesus, do it like you want to do it. You are crying. Have you ever discovered, let me tell you the truth, whenever you are having a problem, there is a problem also that needs to be sorted out.
Amen.
Whenever you have a situation that you want God to sort out for you, there is a situation that God wants you also to sort out for him.
Oh yes.
So your deliverance is embedded in having a desire to put something in order somewhere.
Amen.
So if you want this anointing for impact, have an eye that sees what you should be doing.
Oh, yes.
Have an eye that sees situation that needs to be sorted out.
Amen.
I don't know if I'm speaking to someone.
Amen.
This crying will never take you anywhere.
Amen.
So, number one, I saw that Nehemiah said, even if I am not there, but there is a situation. But what I wanted to show you was this. The most important thing that I want to deal with today is information. And how you treat information. This guy Hanani came with information from Jerusalem. And he was kind of like addressing the Jews who were captives in Babylon. And of all the Jews, they took that information as simple information. The walls are broken, but the people are also in great turmoil. And everybody just said, So how did you travel? How was your journey? I know you are not hearing what I'm trying to show you. If you don't know how to treat information that you receive, you will never get an anointing from on high to make impact.
Yes.
You should learn to take information uncommonly. The greatest problem that we have is you don't know how to treat information. I don't know, can I try? The greatest problem that Christians have, they don't know how to treat information. Every information that they receive, they treat it commonly. But one thing that made Nehemiah to stand out was he treated common information uncommonly. To others it was common, but he treated it uncommonly, number one. And he saw an agency in that information. The reason why you are poor, the reason why nothing is happening to you is because you are sitting down. But the reason why you are sitting down is there is no information that moves you to do something. Why? Because you treat information commonly. I know I'm speaking.
Amen.
So Nehemiah, when he had this information, he didn't took it lightly like we do. He didn't took that information lightly. He considered it as something that really needed to be sorted out. Let me help you. Do you know why you are poor? The information that you are poor is not like you have not been given it. But how you treated it is what causes you to remain poor. The reason why we are not changing our statuses in life is because the information that tells us that this is not good. Even if we are given that information, we receive it and we just treat it as normal information. I know. It has not yet been heard what I'm trying to bring. Can I show you something? Stand up. If you ask me. Let's say, God bless you. If you ask me, Apostle, tell me information that will cause me to do something. And I tell you, you are renting. But because that is now common information to you, do you know even if I tell you, you are still a lodger, you will not fast and pray, you will not cry. Because how you receive it and how you treat that information is what determines who you will become. So when Nehemiah was presented with this information that the ruins, the city is in ruins and the people are in great turmoil, he didn't took that information lightly.
Amen.
pretend as if everything is normal. Yet my father's sepulchers are now lying in ruins. The city has been burnt. And here I pretend as if everything is normal. I am saying, listen, you are on him. Say, listen to this. I know the information that I have just told you is this. You are poor.
Yes.
You are renting.
Yes, Lord.
You came here by combi.
Yes, Lord.
You are not married.
Yes, Lord.
You are barren.
Yes, Lord.
Now tell three people, I'm going to do something about this information.
I'm going to do something.
Wait. I don't think you are hearing me. It will take 20 years for you again. Even your best tells me there is no agent in this matter. For how long have you been renting? Now, if you don't put agents in this matter today, tell somebody. Do not tolerate anything that is not in accordance with the word of God.
Yes.
What did I say? This as if they are good situations. How do you eat in one room like you are in your own room? I suppose you carry the money.
Yes,
Lord. Song.
Yes, Papa.
Oh, it's a great message. If you don't have it, come, I'll give it to you.
Yes,
it's something serious.
Yes, Lord.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, Papa.
Ah! This is not the time to wear jackets.
Ah, yes, Papa.
Sure.
Hello, somebody. Ay, ay, ay.
Yes, Papa.
Ay, ay, ay. The time for us to wear jackets will come.
Yes, Lord.
Are you hearing what I'm saying, somebody?
Yes, Papa.
I don't know if I'm preaching to somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Now, watch this. Nehemiah says, when I received that information, I cried.
Yes.
But you, if you were told you are ending.
Sure. I'm ready.
Issues that when you listen to and meditate upon, I want to tell you what will move God is how you treat your situation. We are talking about you receiving an anointing that will take you out from that place. But that information is what causes you to say no. This tent is a very big tent. If somebody doesn't come to you and ask you, why are you crying? It means you're not ready to see change.
I know someone.
Yes, Papa. If you really consider a type of information you receive as a common, some of you, you should not be doing what you're doing. Your actions shows you have not regarded or considered your state. So when Nehemiah says, this is not good. And he said, I cried. I what?
I
cried. Let me show you something. Go to Nehemiah chapter 1. Go to verse. Sit down. I want to show you something. Do you want this anointing?
Yes, Papa.
I heard these words that I sat down and wept. You know, Tagari Sikam Nam Tajairana Nekshupika.
You still stand up and laugh and go and do crazy things.
But Nehemiah said, I sat down, meditating upon what I was told. Then I what? I wept. And mourned 7 days. 12 days of mourning and weeping.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hello, somebody.
Amen. Then I fasted.
How many are still fasting?
Yes, Father.
At least you have started.
Amen.
And prayed before the God of heaven. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
And said, I beseech thee, O Lord God of heaven, the great and terrible God that keepeth covenant.
Now. The word covenant is what I want you to consider also. What will cause you to cry after hearing somebody is a function of knowing the covenant that you are in. If the covenant says to Abraham, I shall give you a land of your own, and your descendants shall be possessors of that land, and you know you are in the same covenant that Abraham did with our God, then you should know I should be possessing my own piece of land. So what causes you to cry is, I am renting, yet the covenant gave me land. So this is a situation that is contrary to what Abraham agreed with his God. If it is a covenant that made Abraham to be rich in silver, rich in gold, rich in cattle, rich in land, that is what should move us. So the reason why Nehemiah cried, mourned, then fasted and prayed is because he understood the words I received are contrary to what God said we must be enjoying.
Amen.
So some of you, the reason why you are not moved, even if you are told your state, is only because you don't even know what you should do. But I'm here to tell you, if you don't know it, you should be living a better life than you are living. There is a reason for you to cry. You should be enjoying better amounts of money than what you are receiving. So there is a better reason for you to cry. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you are barren, the Bible says barrenness shall not be part of anybody who is an Israelite. If you are sick, the Bible says, I will burn the sicknesses of Egypt from among the camp of the children of God. So if you know the covenant, and you are told by your doctor you are HIV positive, and you say, you begin to say, that's what should cause you to cry and mourn. Then begin to seek the face of Jehovah and say to God, you are a covenant keeping God. Somebody stand up and tell God, this is not good.
This is not good.
That is happening to me.
That is happening to me.
Whatever caused me to be in this situation.
Whatever caused me to be in this situation.
I know you are a covenant keeping God.
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 Hear my prayer, O Lord.
Hear my prayer, O Lord.
I confess the sins that we have committed.
I confess the sins that we have
committed. And I confess the sins that were committed by my forefathers.
And I confess the sins that were committed.
I don't want to remain in these ruins.
I don't want to remain
poor. I don't want to remain poor.
I don't want to remain barren.
I don't want to remain barren.
This is bad information.
This is bad information.
I'm treating it uncommonly.
I'm treating it uncommonly.
Because I want anointing from on higher.
An anointing that will make me stand out.
Sit down.
So this is one of the things why Nehemiah was anointed with this anointing. He chose to treat common information uncommonly. Tell your neighbor, from today, I am treating
common information
uncommonly. If you want to see anybody who stood out, that's the character. Anybody who will stand up. The difference between people who make it in life and people who are just at the same place is, you should be able to treat information differently. Let me show you something.
Can I deal with someone?
Yes, Lord.
Let me just be a father today and help someone.
Yes, Lord.
This is your problem. You don't change step. If you have one step from Friday to Friday, forget about making money. Papa, don't change step. Don't change step. Huh? Walk, go there. Don't change step. I said what? Robbie, come here. He changed. I said, don't go. Robbie, come here. Robbie, rush and take something from them. This guy is too slow. Okay. But you saw what I wanted to show you. Why are you having the same step, yet there are different kinds of words being spoken to you? This is a sign that you don't have an ear that hears where there is a need for agency, where there is a need for seriousness, where there is a need for you to even change clothes. The reason why some of you are still who you are, no information causes you to burn. No information will cause you to even go and have a head to. Now, when Joseph was told, go to jail, he went to jail. We are not told of anything about his countenance or his hair or his clothes. But when he received the word that you are needed in the king's palace, the Bible tells us he shaved his hair.
Oh, yeah.
What caused Joseph to act in a certain way is the type of information he has received. What does this information require? But if it was you, you are going to the king. You should listen. I think God help me explain this to your people. You know, there is nothing boring like dealing with somebody who doesn't know the difference of things that we are doing. We have people. Just tell me.
Yes, Papa.
Who don't even know the difference of being in a soccer field and at a workplace and at an interview. That's why their lives will never change, because they don't know how to treat information. If you receive information and treat it uncommonly, that information should tell you what to wear. That information should tell you the step to use that day. That information should even tell you even what to eat or not to eat. I am telling you the truth. There is a certain type of information that when you receive, there is no need for you to eat. But you,
the best of each cup,
I don't know if I'm speaking to people who want this anointing. We are praying and fasting, but at the same time, information about this issue is what I am giving you today. Some of you were not fasting because you didn't do this, but after today you will join us.
Yes, Lord.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, Papa.
So tell your neighbor, do not tolerate anything.
Do not tolerate anything
that is not in accordance with the word of God.
That is not in accordance with the word of God.
Then the other thing is, personalize that information. I'm still on information. The problem that we are having in any nation or in any country, or let me say in our church, let me try to personalize this information also. This is the problem we have in our church. Nobody personalizes information. Whenever there is nobody personalizing information, nothing will be done, even if there is something that is in disorder. As long as Nehemiah is still in a group, nothing will happen. Are you seeing it took one man for the whole building to be built?
problem is people want group work. The problem of group work is this. If Nehemiah had sought to encourage somebody to do it, he was going to be discouraged.
Amen.
So the reason why Nehemiah managed to accomplish his vision, he didn't sought anybody, even a friend.
Hallelujah.
Before the stages that he needed help with, he just began to cry on his own to his God, and he said, this is not good. He didn't say, Mark, this is not good. Let us go to the mountain and pray and fast. Personalize. What did I say?
Personalize.
Information. What did I say?
Personalize information.
Your problem is you are waiting to join somebody to do it. Yet God is not looking for anybody. He is looking for one man to anoint with an anointing that will then cause others to follow suit.
Amen.
God is looking for the pioneer of this project.
Oh, yes.
The one who will stand up and say, by my God,
Amen.
We will accomplish this thing.
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
So you need to what? To what? Tell your neighbor, personalize information.
Personalized information.
If information comes, let it be yours. Like right now, I'm preaching to the whole church. But if you think this is a message for the whole church, you are missing it. It's your personal message.
Yeah.
We are looking for people who will say, that was my message. Do you know why? You have never heard anybody say that. Everybody will be saying, nobody will ever say, guys, today you accompanied me to church. That was my message.
Oh, yes.
You are not yet personalizing the message. Tell your neighbor, this is my message.
This is my message.
You are just here to help me hear my message. Then the other thing that will cause this anointing to rest upon you is fasting and praying. Oh, I heard only one person.
Yes, Lord.
Raw oil for impact will only rest on fasting machines. If you are not yet a fasting machine, now I have a lot of enemies more than friends. Let me tell you something. The more you fill your stomach, the more you empty your destiny. If you want your tomorrow to be influential and impactful, empty your stomach. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Empty your stomach and seek the face of God for grace. I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody. You know, let me tell you the truth. Some of you, the states you are in, doesn't demand you to have breakfast. Some of you, you should cancel breakfast and give God a deadline that unless this happens, I am not going to be having breakfast. You don't want to be told the truth. You are just crying. Let us discuss this issue. You are just crying. What have you done about it? Now, watch this. We are dealing with Nehemiah.
Yes.
Nehemiah was saving the king. That automatically shows you the type of food that he was exposed to. But he sacrificed that food for a greater goal that he intended. Let me try. What are you eating? What is it that you are calling breakfast that you cannot leave for prayer? Let's say it. Ask your neighbor right now. Some of us, we are fasting and you have eaten. But let's see what chanyanya kuba chapita ukundi kani zanya chikafuzi.
Yeah.
this foot hurts. Ah, but the other one is this foot, is this foot. Is this what you call foot? Let's talk this thing. What have you eaten? Some of us, we are fasting. But you, we have eaten. But okay, let's say wakundika na mzulegeza ne kuna kwe mani kwe shashashwa kwa ita shi. Aosiri wawo na kati ndamu ya rupo kwenye ausani wandi ipaita na nasi ne kuna kwe chikafu chiliko huu. Andinele uti ndukamu ya kumpa kwa mani. Mwanga ane wakati uyani. One reason why you see now kundi daiza na unachika abisuta usiku chikafa ni chikafa hakuna. Dozo otati na kutanya ishu ishu ayo chiposu isa pa melimogo otishu ishu ishu ayo raw oil for impact. Who only rest upon those who are fasting machines. Now, if I ask some of you, besides this fasting that we have started together, you know you will sit with the step of somebody after fasting for only a day, only a day. Then you can see this person is doing it maybe for the first time after 9 to 10 months. Oh, let me tell you the truth. I was laughing the whole week. And I was even telling my wife, look at this one. Look at this one. And my gen is a number later, number now, Pambasa Mike. Oh, for the first time in history, they see one day Japan. One was a nature past, nature. Then I said to my wife, let me look for these guys. They go to my chair and I open up the room. Where's that guy pass? Put to the. And I began to ask, put to the Puri and my God to go what? May God give you grace to be a fasting machine. I see. Look at the life of anybody who became a hero in the word of God. They were fasting machines. Let me tell you something. Don't listen to some of the things that these men of God teach you when they are up there. They will be lying. Point number one, point number two, point number three. Those guys lived in the bushes fasting. If you don't fast, forget about power. If you don't fast, tell me if you don't fast.
If you don't fast,
forget about some of these things that you desire to hear. So Nehemiah says what? And I cried, I mourned, and I what? And I fasted for certain days. Hello?
Yes.
What? Certain days. And fasted and prayed before the Lord of heaven. So you should be ready to fast and what? And pray. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Then the other thing that you need to do if you want this anointing to come upon you is sacrifice. Yeah. What?
Sacrifice.
Sacrifice. Let's look at Nehemiah's life. And look at the things that he managed to sacrifice. Hello, somebody. Now. Do you know Kuti? Sometimes every year we smile, smile, smile. Now we are pushing. Come to look sacrifice one.
Amen.
You sacrifice those loves for a certain type of face. Ah. Let me tell you something. If you are working in the king's presence, for the sake of visitors that comes to visit the king,
you are even trained how to smile. So when you hear the king saying to Nehemiah, why are you not smiling? It means whenever you enter into the presence of the king, you should be smiling. But when we see what we know you should be doing, not being done, it means you have sacrificed that for something.
Yeah.
And the king said, why? Because I know you, Nehemiah. You are not sick. I have not received a report that one of your attendances are lying, are sick. So I know you are not sick. You are well. This is not because you are sick. This is because something is not well. Then Nehemiah said, what? How do I smile?
Yes, Lord.
When my father's sepulchre lies in ruins. Hello, somebody. How do I smile? Number one. Number two, when Nehemiah said, and fasted, I already told you, he was working in the king's kitchen. Huh? And that's a great sacrifice for you to fast whilst you are serving somebody food. You are saving not only anybody, but the king who is served with the most delicious food, the best recipes, the best soup, the smells in the kitchen of where the king's food is cooked in. And then man says, for certain days, entering into that kitchen every day, but for certain days fasting. Are you ready for your miracle?
Yes, Lord.
Do you want to be anointed?
Yes, Lord.
Sacrifice. What is sacrifice? Sacrifice is leaving something for something that is better. So there is a level. Your problem is you don't know better things. You treat everything the same. That's why you think this food is very, very good. I cannot throw it into the bin because it is, oh, this is brisket. And the expense of your own kettle, you swallow brisket at the expense of your kettle business. So you need to see something that is special but temporary. And then you need to have an eye that knows if we do this thing, this will be permanent brisket in our own land. But in some of you, we're not going to have 2 minutes. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Sacrifice. Tell your neighbor, sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
Tell your neighbor, sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
And anything that you don't sacrifice for, you don't believe in. If you believe you are going to build a house and you are not ready to sacrifice, you don't believe in building that house. If you believe you should buy a car and you don't sacrifice for it, you are not believing in it. Tell your neighbor, anything you don't sacrifice for, you don't believe in. Anything you don't sacrifice for, you don't believe in. And let me tell you something. When we say sacrifice, people think because we are now in grace, because we are now under Jesus, we don't have to encounter pain. We can never talk about sacrifice and leave pain.
Yes, Papa.
If you don't sacrifice, you don't believe in it. But if the sacrifice is not painful, it's not sacrifice.
Oh, yes.
I don't know if you're hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
You need to rest too much. You need comfort zones too much. Now I don't have people who still want this grace. Do you want especially this Nehemiah time?
Yes.
Do like what he did. I was praying one day. And God said to me, the problem with a lot of people is they desire things that are on certain people, but they don't want to do what those people do.
Amen.
If you want the anointing that is upon a certain man of God, you should know what he does.
Amen.
Being prayed for by that person is not enough, because you should know how to keep what you have gotten from that person. Ask. I was studying the lives of the richest people to ever live, and I found something in common with these guys. Somebody say sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
If you have ever read Bill Gates' books, he speaks in every one of his books that he sleeps how many hours?
4 hours.
A man who is worth more than 60 billion is sleeping 4 hours. How much are you worth? Or if you are even worth something, you are not worth even a dollar. I was talking with my wife. I don't know what we wanted. And my wife said, go. And she spoke another name of another son of ours who is in this church right now. And I said, don't even try. And my wife said, I think he knows what we want. And I said, this person, ever since I tried calling that person after 8 o'clock, that person has got serious sleeping grace. The grace doesn't even allow a phone call to wake him up. I don't know if you are hearing what I'm saying. Do you know that if you are not ready to sacrifice things that are very hard to sacrifice, you are not ready to prosper? If you want to learn sacrificing, start by sleep. What did I say? If I was to prophesy, I know I didn't say that we must all come here at 5:30 to pray. I said, wherever you are, that is our time to pray. But were you praying at 5 o'clock? At 5:30? Oh, you see, somebody is not answering his nose. So it won't shock you that even from the day that I gave that instruction, somebody has never prayed at 5:30 until today. We are almost halfway through our fasting and praying. The instruction is 5:30, even in your house. But have you done even one day? You. Oh, if you didn't, I have to pray. You are disobedient. You are not only disobedient. So are you seeing that laziness and not able to, that the lacking the ability to sacrifice will cause you to be disobedient? Because you cannot sacrifice, you choose to even be disobedient to an instruction. And then continue fasting the whole day in disobedience. Because of not sacrificing. So if you are not ready to sacrifice certain things in your life, forget about anointing. Anointing is for sacrificers. And I know when we say sacrifice, you automatically think we are talking about money or giving. It's part of that. But most of the things that you need to sacrifice is not only money. If you begin to grow in the things of God, you discover that when God says sacrifice money, and you begin to sacrifice, God will even change. Because God doesn't want your money. The reason why God demands money the most is because it is one of the hardest things for you to sacrifice. So when you pass the area of money, you even see God changing even to time. He will even change to sleeping, sacrifice, wake up 12 o'clock, pray. Why? He is just looking for the things that are not easy for you to do. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
How many want grace? How many want grace?
Yes, Lord.
Sacrifice. What did I say?
Sacrifice.
What did I say?
Sacrifice.
What did I say?
Sacrifice.
What did I say?
Sacrifice.
But I don't know about that. I would turn him in. Tell your neighbor, sacrifice.
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 One thing that Nehemiah also sacrificed was he was in the king's palace. But he left the palace for the jungle.
If you want this anointing, be ready to sacrifice something.
Amen.
That's only what I'm trying to show you. How can you leave the palace for the bush, for a place where there is rubbles, a heap of rubbles and ashes? But that is exactly what you need for you to attract sacrifice. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Some of you are very happy in the palace, but remember you are a servant. Being in the palace does not mean you are in the right place. Both, you can be in the palace, but if you are a servant, it's better for you to go to the bush and begin to build your own palace.
Amen.
Do you know there are people who serve kings with delicious meals and then go back to their boy scouts and eat Minotto. So there is a level that you should say, I'm in the palace, but I should be in the bush. This is the time for me to be in the bush. I might be in the palace, but exactly the time according to God is saying bush. Sacrifice. But because you don't want to sacrifice, you see as if me. Let me jump that part. There is a time that you should look at yourself and you say, I'm wellness with me. Can you give me a work suit, please?
Yeah.
Hey. Am I speaking to somebody?
Yes.
So, sacrifice can best be explained also using circumcision. You know, circumcision is also sacrifice. The circumcision they used to do, they used to cut off a piece of their flesh, which means unless you feel the pain, you have not what? Unless you lose something and you feel the pain, you have not sacrificed. I was talking to these guys yesterday. Can I testify? Can I give you an example?
Yes, Papa.
You know, we were preaching in Kwekwe, I think. We were preaching in Kwekwe when? Thursday and Friday.
Yes,
but we were fasting and praying.
Yes, Papa.
Traveled fasting. Preached fasting. Thursday afternoon, preached fasting. Evening, preached fasting. After preaching, drove back here. Past 6, I'm receiving a phone call. A friend is having a show somewhere. And this is a man who is always here, who is always with us. For the sake of my relationship with that person, went home, changed, bathed, changed, and went to that show. And we came from that show what day?
Past 11.
And these guys were saying, they were no longer speaking now. They were just saying, this man. But are you seeing that most of the time that you will be feeling I'm tired, that's when an opportunity to sacrifice appears?
Yes.
Because sacrificing will not happen when you don't have anything to do. You have to sacrifice.
Oh, yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because of our time, I receive by the action that God has vested upon my life.
I receive
by apostolic mandate.
I receive.
You are God protected this holy day.
I receive.
I say, no matter what will be happening in the roads, you are exempted from any accident in Jesus' name.
I receive.
I said, you are exempted. Have you ever ministered the word said?
Yes,
I. What do you do?
An assistant pastor in Swaziland.
I saw you ministering as I was ministering here.
I saw you ministering. And I saw fire coming out of your mouth.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Do not be afraid to proclaim the gospel of liberty to the people of God.
Thank you, ma'am.
God is going to do crazy things through your life.
Thank you, ma'am.
And if you can take my word today, your prosperity is in doing God's work. Thank you, ma'am. Very soon, this is what I'm doing. Very soon, what did I say?
Very soon,
you shall become a voice. Thank you, ma'am. God is about to finish with you. You was going under some sort of training, some sort of whatever pit, whatever struggles you was going through, something. But God was molding a fire preacher, and you will see what God will do with you. God is raising, God is raising a giant in the form of you.
Thank you,
bless you for being here. May the anointing, the Nehemiah anointing for impact be your portion also.
Thank you, Lord.
Who else before we go and eat? Nobody is ready.
Prophesy, Papa.
Prophesy, Papa.
I'm serious.
Prophesy, Papa.
Prophesy. Okay, put your hands down, 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 put your hands down. I saw your phone being raised today. Who was raising your phone? A phone. Are you connected to any twins in your life? Any twins? Or do you know any twins in your life?
No.
Something I saw something like a double. I don't know. What do you do?
I'm a police officer.
You are a police officer?
Yes.
There is going to be a double reward before 20%. Because I saw twins standing with you. I saw twins standing with you. And it was like there was a connection between you and those twins. And then as I asked, I thought they are twins that I am connected to. But God interpreted it to me as He wants to give you a double. When you say it, I know it doesn't make any sense, but there is going to be a double reward. A double reward. Have you completed a year as a full-time officer?
No.
Yeah. People are going to be shocked because God said to me, tell this young man that the things that are not normally done for anybody who is not over a year is going to be done to you for the first time.
Yes!
Something good is about to happen to you.
Who else?
Prophesy, Papa.
Prophesy, Son of Major. Yes, Lord.
Now, this is your problem. Can I help you? When you build an altar, things went okay. But then you should have known that my solution is altar. Then you did it and your children were healed, were okay. But you stop. Yet others are continuing to build others in the other side. The only solution is continue building altars for your family and for your children. So that whatever attack, the devil will attack. Your issue doesn't need prayer. Your issue needs you to just build altars. Continue to give. There is something that was upon your heart after you harvested last year that you have set aside to give to God. What happened to that portion?
Yeah.
Your problem is you vowed to God and you gave. It's not bad to give, but sometimes, was an alien and unfulfilled vow. So it was good we have set aside something to give to God, but sometimes when you vow it, standing on a certain altar, just do it, like you're saying.
Thank you, Baba.
So what I just want you to do, you are going to be shown. Just build an altar and things will run out.
Thank you, man of God.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We serve the Lord of the Spirit.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. How many believe he is still speaking?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. God is still speaking.
God is still speaking.
He is speaking every time.
He is speaking every time.
But we hear him here and there.
But we hear him here and there.
But he doesn't speak, stop speaking.
But he doesn't stop speaking.
He speaks every time.
He speaks every time.
But we hear him.
But we hear him
sometimes.
Sometimes.
But he speaks every time.
But he speaks every time.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Yes, Papa.
Who else? I'm looking for, I'm determined to speak to certain people before I come down.
How many son? How many son?
I spoke to how many people?
Three.
I spoke to how many people?
Three.
Your issue is very simple. You. Your issue is very simple. Yours, do you know why I'm coming to you after that one? The reason why I'm coming to you after that one is only because your issue doesn't need any guidance or what. It just needs you to. Do you know? Let me tell you something.
Yes, Papa.
We have got a serious situation that we will always be involved in because of our tribes, or our tradition.
Yes, Papa.
There are, we have churches, we have that this is the Hama.
Yes, Papa.
But I'm not that you cannot identify the same content as you said.
Yes, Papa.
So you are facing a very serious situation that needs one thing that I'm going to help you with right now.
Okay, Papa.
Can I help you?
Yes!
Because you are worried.
Yes,
you are worried,
Papa.
About this non-being thing, yet you are. You are the only person. As you tell him, say that because Jimmy, one man, two from
Shepard.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa. Yes,
Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
You just build an altar and go.
Thank you, Papa.
Yes, Papa. Go. Whatever that you do, in your sign, you put it under my mouth, the Papa mouth.
Thank you, Papa.
I saw people planning to do a lot of evil things on that Nehemiahs thing. Yes, Lord. I saw a lot of people planning to do a lot of.
If you are under this anointing,
yes, Lord.
Yes.
Whatever they will do to you,
yes, Lord.
It shall not work.
I receive it.
I said it shall not work.
I receive it.
I said it shall not work.
I receive it.
Once I began to hear. People asking your son about you not being married, like your husband dying before finishing to give cows.
Yes, Papa.
I heard people discussing that it will be sorted out on that day.
Thank you, Papa.
And they are waiting to just do crazy stuff, but I saw it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Benjamin.
What did I say?
You saw it, Papa.
I saw it and I'm dealing with it right now.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Benjamin.
No, it's not my personal profit. I don't know what it is. Not that way, I saw it. I don't know what it is.
Oh, yes.
Yes, Lord. They won't do anything bad that will haunt your children or you.
Thank you, Papa.
Don't be.
Yes, Papa, I have you.
You and me.
Yes, you are my father.
I am your father.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, daughter. Continue speaking.
You are my father, you are my helper.
By the word I said, yes, sir. You are covered.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't be afraid.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't be afraid.
Because I saw somebody trying to say,
Are you married?
You? You're not married.
This is my sister.
Oh, so this is your brother-in-law.
Mom-in-law.
Mom-in.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yes, Baba.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Prophesy, Papa.
You know anybody who does something connected with mechanics?
In my family.
You?
Me? Yeah, yes. He started this plant meeting.
Which one?
My uncle.
Okay.
Prophesy, Papa.
Prophesy! So, you did apprentice? You?
Yes, I actually trained at Berwick Polytechnic.
And like an apprentice?
Like an apprentice, yes.
But what are you now, you?
You are currently an apprentice.
Okay.
Professor.
What are you doing as an apprentice?
Electrical power.
Electrical power?
Yes, sir.
This one?
Yeah, it's along those lines.
Okay. What's your vision? I saw somebody getting a great vision about what he's learning. What's your vision?
To do well with my studies and become a very good engineer.
Then what?
Possibly serve God.
I saw God giving you a great vision after finishing this thing.
I receive God.
But if you want it, receive it right now. Because
I receive God.
There's an area in your area that you are going to become a solution.
I receive God.
I don't know, in your area, is it possible for people to have their companies and begin to apply for tender?
Yes, Baba.
Because I saw you getting a vision where there will be a connection up there that will just sort out things for you.
I receive, Baba.
Or if you receive it, receive it like you want.
I receive, Baba.
Number five.
Prophesy, Papa.
Prophesy, Papa.
And you came to my rescue.
Number five. Who's number five? We want to go and eat, please. Look at that.
My sisters.
Oh,
what baby mama?
Both parents are dead. Yes.
Because I saw somebody who was standing alone.
It's true, Baba.
Even Kutimusum Tora, it was kind of like that was the best thing for her.
Yes, Baba. It's true.
But we serve a mighty God.
Wow. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Number four.
Give you grace to change your family life.
You can also receive it.
I receive it. I take it, Papa. Yes, Lord.
You, gray is better than young.
Hey, I am the one who want to prophesy to this person. Now listen to me.
Are you going to go back to school after this? Is it apprenticeship? What do you call it that you are doing now?
I'm going to school back after attachment.
Oh, so this is attachment. That's what I'm asking about.
Yes. Sir.
So after this attachment, you are going to?
To school again.
For how long?
For 1 year.
1 year. What are you doing?
I'm doing banking and finance.
Banking and finance.
Yes, Papa.
You know, I know, Professor, bring your water here, you. If I be a man of God,
yes.
I want this, our daughter, to receive a great anointing for it.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa.
Now, there is a reason why I'm saying that. Don't think, but the rest of our companies are good. They even know what is going to happen if you finish. So their plan is you must not finish. But my plan also is you must finish. I anoint you for one thing. Finish your studies. This is an anointing for you to just finish your studies. You will finish. In Jesus' name. That my daughter whom I prayed for before I ministered. Ka Ayarash. As I was ministering to that one, I saw you. Mabere
Gogoro. Dukana na mama, wana separate na tete.
They separated. So, do you go kwa baba?
And what do you na tena mbena mbuko mduka na mbaza kwa
wajitu? I want to pray for you.
Amen.
Yes, I pray for you today. This sickness comes to an end. Hold your hands. Put both of your hands. Father, I pray. I release your healing anointing. May she be made whole. This weakness, I break it. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Be free. Now receive anointing and be healed. Receive grace and be healed. Receive grace and be healed. I heal you by the power of the living God.
Yes, yes,
Lord. It falls down. It leaves you.
Yes, Lord.
From right now.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Dancing to give, come.
Lord, I am with you.
You can't believe it.
do you do?
I make a little boy.
May the life of this man prophesy, Papa. You know, I want this man to be blessed. From yes, deep down my heart, I want this man to be blessed.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Papa.
And one of the reasons is this: you'll be shocked with the God who speaks.
Yes,
Lord. Sunday service. Desire your name to Jesus. Say.
Ah,
sorry. Nini? Can I open that up? What's up? Never change the Sunday service. Desire all of my magic at least. Say,
I want to be a man of God.
Listen, you are missing my. I am prophesying good. You are only so not my work at least. To come out here, come out Sunday. Put out the Jesus.
I want in the off days.
On what?
On Sundays.
Normally you
or include in Saturdays.
Okay. So normal language people are off as well.
I know anything.
Not even a single day.
Yes.
So I desire again that people want to go to Albutin, don't have a member of Jehovah every Sunday. So I will find that one off. Yes, sir. I was going to be off church.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Jehovah, I was a connector. Eco, which talk about you, which mix of being Lamin. Cherry and I want to go out to our room to go to them and change it up. The ring and the song they want to Jehovah and I'll wait until now.
Yes, Papa.
I lay my hands upon you.
Yes.
I lay my hands upon you.
Yes, Lord.
How did you come here? What's your answer?
Papa, Bangandu Mbarango Karaum, but he Varanandu is staying there. Vakati anzi varukuda mukomana wakasa kuharara ndobvandazo uya kunoko but pandakauya kunoko
no pana kwete option pana muchechi wakasvika sei church mano
the first day ndakangosvika panapa ndakasvika panze ndobva ndamira ndamira panze ndakaona vanhu vakamira panze then ndakatombo like panika kakutya ndakava kutenderera ndikakwidza kumusoro kwegolf ndikatendera ndichitiza panapa ndobva ndatendera ndabva ndasiuva ndasvika kuzasi vandatimirei masekend ndakazvipa kakungozviruma muromo like ndakandakupinda muchechi ndakangobva ndakokwidza masteps pendakasvika ndobva ndagasherwa nemamwe masisters ndobva ndapiwa nzvimbo yeuka
vatogara
and at the other basis, my Sundays, maybe that will be a pastor, but you cheated over there. I'm
going to do Asha, Dad.
I'm going to do Asha.
Prophesy, come on. Yeah! Glory, glory, glory. God be spoken by more. God be spoken by more. God be spoken by more. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Uchaimba song yekuti Jesu wangu wane hanya neni.
Yes, sir.
Vanobvisa apa, vanobvisa apa, vanobvisa ipapo, vanobvisumudzira.
Yes, sir.
Nekuti vane hanya neni.
Yes, Papa.
I prophesy with my eyes closed and with my eyes open.
Yes, Major.
You shall not remain on that job.
Yes, sir.
I push you to a better job in the name of Jesus.
I refuse, Major.
You shall marry your wife.
Yes, Papa.
You shall have a wedding.
I refuse.
With your own children.
I refuse.
You shall change your generation.
I refuse.
Because you came to the house of God.
I refuse.
May the anointing of Jehovah be upon your head.
Yes, Papa.
May your car begin to run over.
I refuse.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Celebrate this life. Celebrate
this life. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
You can do better for this good God.
Yes, Lord.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of our God, the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us.
Be with us
from now. Until we meet again tomorrow in the evening. Amen.
Amen.
Good people, may the Lord God bless you.
Yes, sir.
Do we have people who say we have never been in this church? We are visitors, or sit down. This is very important. We are visitors, or we have joined this church. Either visitors or those who joined us today. Whether you are visitors or you have joined us today, can I just see you? Can you just raise your hands? Whether visitors or joining us today, can you stand up? Stand up. What are you waiting for?
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Now I want you to stand up and give them a greater life welcome. Hallelujah! Glory be to our Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Sit down. So we want to welcome these people to Greater Life Embassy. Our visitors also, we welcome you at Greater Life Embassy. May the God accept.
Yes, Lord.
Do something for you this week as a sign that you met with an anointing in the name of God.
I receive you. Yes, Lord.
By your presence in this place today, I declare a cancellation of debt.
Outstanding bills.
What about yours? Where is your husband?
I don't know where you chat.
Are you together?
I just get a text this morning.
You just see each other?
Yes.
Why are you not living together like me, like what I'm doing with my wife?
I found out that he had another wife.
You found out that he has another wife?
Yes.
Okay, can I help you? I don't want you to feel offended, I don't want you to look down upon yourself, but I want your 2015 to be a new year and a new beginning.
Oh, yes!
How many children do you have with him?
Two.
I don't know how you see what I want to present to you as an option or a choice to choose. What if we say, we leave that one with his wife, and we say, God, 2015, give me somebody of my own. Yeah. How do you see that? It's an option.
Yes, I can take it.
Because I don't want you to wait for him to finish what you'll be doing with his kids and children, then wife, then come to you as a spare wheel for him. Another option.
Oh, yes.
I don't want you to feel like you have sinned or you feel offended, but I want you to have your life starting afresh in 2015.
Oh yes.
By this grace, by this anointing.
Yes, Lord.
May God enable you to just tell him, please, I don't want to be a sparrow. I'm praying to my God so that He gives me my all.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Because there are prayers that I'm picking that are being prayed by the first wife. And we serve a God who hears and answers prayers.
Oh, yes.
So I want you to be blessed under this grace and anointing. We will help you, we will be mentoring you, we will be praying for you. I see, you don't have a problem with finances. I see your hands receiving cash. I don't know, what do you do?
In the house.
You see, she doesn't. I saw her receiving a lot of cash. And God said to me, don't worry about finances. I've already opened the doors for this lady. But now I want to sort out your own personal.
Thank you, Papa.
Who will be there for you 24/7?
Oh, yes.
Do you want that?
Yes, I do.
Sure.
Yes, I do.
Who supports him?
Yes, Lord.
Oh, yes.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I pray that the grace to be able to do it will rest upon you right now in Jesus' name. You will testify.
Thank you, Father.
Sure. If I be a man of God, come here.
Yes.
Yes. Father, I pray for her.
Oh, yes.
Forgive her of her sins.
Yes, Lord.
I bless her for a new life and a new beginning.
Yes, Lord.
Celebrate Jesus, somebody.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I said, celebrate Jesus. And you are turning to your own being. Now, sit down, sit down. We were dealing with credits. We were dealing with credits. Is this a loan or what? Huh?
We need to transport. So, I have a check of the H bank. I have a check of the H bank. The National Physical Bed, and it's like we have paid our forfeit. Now I remember she went in some better money. Last week she got better about $2,000 here. But she's not too much credit in this. Mono I show na aka wataka aka credit aka biro charungo famanut inini maronga non di tira and na kubira but chosen dear katibira.
As we are fasting and praying.
Oh, yes.
Anything that the devil is trying to steal from you, using cruel people.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, yes.
Yes, Lord.
If I be a man of God, this shall be a sign you met with a man of God today.
Oh yes.
You shall be recompensated. You shall be
thank you.
You shall be restored. Everything you lost.
Thank you.
Prophesy, Papa.
Oh yes.
Do you do business in partnership life?
Some of my companies I'm in partnership, I think, for three.
God told me this. And God told me this again.
Amen.
2015.
Yes.
2015.
Yes, sir.
What did I say?
2015.
There is a tender that you applied long back that was supposed to change your status that you are going to be given. I don't know whether it has got something to do with government, but
we do it with the government.
I saw a tender that you are going to be given by the government. You.
Thank you.
That is going to change.
Oh yeah.
They think that your boyfriend is small. This is more small.
Oh yes, Papa.
I saw a tender. That tender,
yes, Lord.
Your company will begin to compete. So don't worry about that credit. It's done. Don't worry about that credit. You will hear. There will be a confession before 31 December. You will hear people confessing to you. People will confess. Amen. So yours is what? I want to, God said to me, these new people, let this be a sign. Death cancellation.
Amen.
What about yours? Oh, do we have anybody who is not new who is death again?
Yeah.
Stand up. I decree and I declare. Debt cancellation in the name of Jesus.
I see.
I say debt cancellation in the name of Jesus.
I see.
Some of you, as we come for crossover night, you'll be testifying debt control.
Yes, sir.
I refuse on your behalf. You shall not enter 2015 with credits.
I receive it.
No carryovers.
Yes, sir.
I said no carryovers.
Yes, sir.
No carryovers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Papa.
Yes,
Lord.
Could never never work faster.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, you know his name is Chitika.
Yes, Papa.
Who can want to own a Obeako Mangwana Chomari?
Yes, sir.
Never be good. God is going to be clear in your day during the night.
Yes, sir.
And God is going to send an angel.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Papa.
An angel who will just use my image to appear in your dream.
Yes, sir.
And it's no longer product GTK.
Yes, Papa. Yes, sir.
Friday, Saturday, the reason why we are only going to be meeting to do prayer, our confessions, is because Friday, Saturday, we are going to be having our Greater Life Conference of the Year. Then on Sunday.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then I'm going to celebrate.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
On Sunday, we will try to go eat. You know, Trump, it's just Sunday with a difference.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Papa.
Number one, my name is Papa. So white is okay on Sunday.
Yes, sir.
This Sunday is going to be a white Sunday.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. White. Daddy G?
White.
And that's my name, Papa.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hello.
Yes, Papa.
And it is going to be a celebration Sunday.
Yes.
What about
Yes, Papa.
How's that you? Amen. Please, man, please, Lord, teach me about that.
Yes, Lord.
I want to dance. The gender going to shout.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I want to dance like dancing is going out of fashion.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Sunday we want to dance. Are you here?
Oh, yes.
Yes, Papa.
So that Sunday also is the Sunday that we are thanking our God. It's a Thanksgiving Sunday.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Appreciation Sunday. Yes. That we are going. Now I don't have people credit.
Oh,
Do the best that you can do for God on that Sunday. Are you
here? Oh,
yes, Papa. It's going to be an awesome time in the presence of Jehovah.
Yes.
So those new people, just go to where Elder Liberty is, that guy raising his hand. Just meet with that guy. He will just tell you something. He will just give you something. that I have blessed you with as people who visited our church today, who joined our church today. So God bless you, good people. Let us meet tomorrow and just break this fasting together. We'll just do our prayer confession.